Sports College Football. I'm Reese Davis, joined here in the booth, as always, by David Pollack and Jesse Palmer. Guys, let's tee this one up. The Gators ready to put toe to leather and get this season started. From a couple of yards deep, he'll bring it out. That gamble did not pay off as they bring it down at the 12-yard line. So SMU's return team didn't help matters out much with that one. And as we watch this wide receiver come onto the field, when you have a dude like this, you find ways to get him the ball over and over again, no matter what the defense tries to take away.
Yeah, because the defense can't win. Whether you double-team him, we're still going to win. And they're going to give him the ball on quick passes. They're going to throw it deep, and they're going to take advantage of him every opportunity they can. They will feed him. They will feature him because he's just that good.
There's always that issue of conference pride, of keeping up, of proving your worth on this stage in the ACC. Love, and this sophomore able to wreak some havoc and get the sack. Gator fans love to see their teams light up the scoreboard, but they'll take the defense bringing the heat too.
And I think that was a staple, Reese. Back in the day, you had great offenses for Florida, but the teams that really had the most success and that reached the highest mountaintops, they had great defense to go with it. This defense playing well.
And the Mustangs will punt this one away. Doesn't say much for your drive when you're looking forward to the punt. Here's the punt, and it is not a very good one. A short punt. A fair catch is called for. It'll give them great field position. So the Florida Gators offense taking the field. First chance we have to see them today. This matchup on the outside, Jesse, a big play weapon for the offense, a shutdown corner for the D.
They say big-time players make big plays in big games, so who gets the best of this matchup? That's going to determine the game.
I mean, such a fun chess match. How much are they on each other during the game, the head-to-head matchup that everybody wants to see?
He's got an open man. Touchdown, Florida! What a catch and run for six. They strike first, and that opening drive of the season could not have gone better.
And this offense gets on the board, and the first passing touchdown of the season, and I feel pretty confident saying the first of many. This offense looks like they're in a good rhythm, and this passing attack's going to be hard to stop.
And he's got the extra point, and it's 7-0 to start this one. That's the kind of drive everybody loves. OC, quarterback, one snap, put it in the end zone. Almost ready to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. And it'll come out to the 25. No attempt at a return. The Mustangs have the ball back and ready to go to work. Last time, David, it was 1-2-3 kick.
The last drive, that three and out, sometimes that puts your defense in a bad spot, and you got to get a drive together here so you don't wear the defense out.
I just think, David, too predictable, that last drive. They got to do something here to get this defense on their heels.
Out of the gun, the running back has it. And this one will be stopped for no gain. As college football evolves, guys, and players have more rights and they capitalize on name, image, and likeness, and teams are in different conferences, maybe the biggest thing and the thing that keeps coaches up at night. And the Heat will get home, and the quarterback goes down at the 17. The Mustangs will line up to punt it away.
And that is a great job by the defense, containing and constricting the pocket. There was nowhere for the QB to go, and he did not have a lot of time. He went down quick.
The Gators sending the offense back to work. David, they'd love to do what they did last time and put this one in the end zone.
You ain't lying. They did a great job. The offense was clicking. Everything went well. Palmer, they executed and got the touchdown.
And they really were in a nice rhythm as well. And I'd love to see that here in the next drive, too. Just keep doing what you're doing. Everything seems to be working, and you seem to have this defense on their heels.
To the ground. He's got it again. Got enough for the first. And he's still running after the move. Touchdown, Gators! He ran through tackles like water through a sieve.
And I bet this coaching staff is jacked up to get this offense firing so fast early in the season, on point. A lot of times it takes time to build the rhythm. It takes time to get it rolling. This offense starting the season off with a bang.
They'll try to add another to their lead. And the extra point makes it 14-0. Only took two plays to find the end zone on that drive, and gashing them on the touchdown run finished it off. They're just about ready to kick it away.
Set to kick this one away.
And it'll be a touchback. The ball will come out to the 25-yard line. The SMU offense is headed back onto the field. To say this has been a slow start is a bit of an understatement, and they really need to get it going here, Jesse.
That's right. The opponent, they're firing on all cylinders right out of the gate. Offensively for this unit, they've been slow and struggling. They need an explosive play to wake themselves up.
Yeah, and it's just the first quarter, so it's not the end of the world. You've seen slow starts, but you got to continue to pick and pick and pick until you find that play or that scheme that you can use against this defense.
Still some work to do after that last completion at second down.
Here we go.
Fast motion from the offense. Quick touch pass to the receiver. The defense wouldn't let him loose there, and it was a completion, but they lost yardage.
The first thing you have to do to make these plays successful offensively is I have to block the edge. I got to get my speedster in space. They didn't do a good job of getting that guy out there in space where he could really use his jets. Nice job by the defense understanding it, seeing it, rallying to it, and tackling that guy for a loss.
And the Heat will get home, and the quarterback goes down at the 17. And the Mustangs will call on their punt team.
What a great job by this defense setting the tone early. In the first half, they've been hitting the quarterback early and often. Make him feel uncomfortable. Make him feel that pressure. Keep getting him on the ground. That's why they built the lead.
First snap of this drive will come from the 46. Off the play fake on first down. Got it in the middle. It's Burke. They stop him just short of the first down, but it will be second and inches coming up. Less than a yard to go to pick up the first down. From the gun, leaves it on the inside with the back. He's got 59 yards on the ground, and they wanted to have an identity as a running team, and he's giving them that in the season opener. They're lining up on first and 10 from the 38. Wide receiver now comes in motion. Wants to throw on first down off the play fake. A strike downfield. They'll mark him down right there, but it is a big play, and they'll move the chains.
Man, this offense is so dangerous, Reese. They've got dudes all over the field that can make plays. There's a big gainer in the pass game.
You get a chunk of yards like that, now the defense is really on its end of the hallelujah land. Touchdown, Florida! Lining up to tack one more onto that lead. And he made that extra point, the wet turf, no problem at all. Quick work on that scoring drive, just four plays. And they cap the drive with a four-yard touchdown pass. Kickoff team has the ball teed up, and they're about ready to go. And he'll just take a knee, and this drive will start at the 25. The Mustangs have the ball back and ready to go to work. Their drive chart is starting to look a little monotonous. Punt, 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 David.
And their defense is starting to get a little frustrated, too. They just keep putting me back on the field, possession after possession. Jesse, this offense needs to get their heads out of their you-know-whats.
The punter's on the sideline with the oxygen mask. He's been playing so much. He's not used to this. This offense, they just got to stay on the field. They've got to put a drive together and get some balance going, running and throwing the ball.
They'll go to the ground. He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of three.
Great job of contained by this defense. And in order to do that, the end man on the line of scrimmage defensively has got to be able to set the point and force the football back into traffic. And that's exactly what happened there.
Trying to make magic with his feet. And he scoops his way to the first down and then slides to avoid the hit. Here's his offense with a fresh set of downs. We've come to the end of the quarter, and it's Florida on top. Man, that was an impressive and dominant first quarter. Let's take a look at the stats before we move on. They'll break the seal on this quarter here on first down.
Get set, get set.
The give to the back. What a nifty run there to pick up the first down. The Mustangs are on the move.
And you're going to hear this guy's name a lot. They're going to ride the big fella. He's such a stud. They're going to build the offense around him. This is just game one, but you're going to get a lot of big runs from this cat.
Last play was a near disaster. Now dealing with second and 13. The handoff to Johnson. Really nice stop there from this senior leader.
And sticking to the run. I'll tell you what, a lot of teams that are really good are really stubborn, and they continue to run the football even with little success. So this offense is going to continue to focus on running the football.
And there was nowhere to go for this quarterback, and down he goes.
Well, I think one of the biggest reasons why this team is finding themselves in a hole here in the first half is this has been a sack party. They can't keep the defense off of their quarterback. They haven't been able to get the ball deep down the field, throwing it with the consistency they want, because they can't keep their quarterback standing up straight.
Florida has the ball back, and here comes the offense. This offense has really been clicking in the game so far, Jesse.
No doubt. Everything their play caller is dialing up, these guys offensively have been able to go out and execute, David.
Yeah, and it's just maintaining the lead. Keep doing what you've been doing. You got a big lead. Let's just keep piling it on until they find an answer.
Here they come, first and 10 from the 48. Really good job working through his progression. You get it to him quickly, and the big tight end has a chance to run a little.
And a really good job by the QB throwing an accurate throw. I got to hit those guys on the move, on the run, so they can do this. They can catch the football, get upfield, and chew up some extra yards.
Pushed back behind the chains. It's first and 15. Quickly complete. At the 35, he's loose. Put it right on him. Sweet play, good pickup, and they'll move the chains with the first down. New set of downs after that completion. Use the play fake, now to throw. Got it behind the line. It's Daniels. And more yards after contact. He was working his way toward that goal line. They'll stop him at the two after the big play up top.
Well, after that last play, you can see how electrifying this guy is and how special he is after he makes the catch. If I'm on offense, I'm trying to find a lot of ways to get him touches in this game.
The give. Close to the end zone, and the ball's out. Oh, and he gets the ball back. Lucky to do so. Guess it could have been worse. And you know the standard is indisputable video evidence, and the officials will change the call. Trying to slam in. And makes his way into the end zone. Touchdown, Gators!
And this offense is firing on all cylinders right now. Starting the year, game one, creating a little bit of a pad and separation at the end of this first half. But you can see why so many people are really excited about this offense this season.
About to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. He'll bring it out. It's golden. That gamble did not pay off as they bring him down at the 12-yard line. The SMU offense is headed back onto the field. That last drive won't go on the highlight reel after ending in a punt. They'd like to be more productive this time, David.
And I think this offense has to be a little bit more balanced. Find a little balance between the run, Jesse, and working in that pass.
And I think, too, David, it's just going to take a spark. It just takes one play to get this thing picked up and going.
Off play action. And he will be sacked at the 6-yard line.
You got to be impressed with this defense early in this game, guys. They've got a big lead because they are getting after the quarterback. They've already generated multiple sacks. They thought coming into this game they could take advantage.
He's going to go down, and he's in his own end zone. It's going to be a safety. After giving up that safety, they'll have to boot it away and give it right back to them. He'll settle for some pretty good field position and make the fair catch at around the 35. The Gators sending the offense back to work. That last drive, an absolute aerial assault for the touchdown, Jesse.
But it was a nice job in play calling, too, David, just giving the quarterback some easy looks and reads so he could go out and execute.
And he knew exactly where to go with the football. Everything looked really, really easy. He was hot.
Oh, look out. There he goes. The 20. Inside the 10. Touchdown, Florida. And once he got loose, it was all over. On to attempt the try. And with the extra point, the lead is even bigger. And for a quick update, let's go to Kevin Connors in the studio.
Boys, if it's happening in college football, we've got eyes on it. Check this out. Texas Tech is showing little remorse for its opponent today. Feels like ever since they arrived at the stadium, that Red Raiders offense has been a buzzsaw. They're up 14 over Bowling Green. We'll circle back if anything big happens you should know about.
And how about that one? Kevin will be keeping an eye on everything going on elsewhere.
I think this quarterback now at this point is looking over to the sideline saying, hey, can we just not throw it anymore? I mean, my guys, they can't block for me. I've got no chance back here. We need to just run the ball from this point.
Man, that's a big missed opportunity for the running back. I'm trying to find ways to feature this guy and get him the football in space and not just hand it to him all the time. And tell you what, I'm a lot less likely to find those plays if he can't reel in those catches.
They stop him after a short game, probably just wanted to mitigate the losses with fourth down coming. And the Mustangs send out the punt unit. Three and out, they got stuck in reverse. They hope the punt can bail them out. I wouldn't quite call it a shank, but that's not exactly going to go on the resume reel. Florida has the ball back, and here comes the offense. After that last explosive running play, David, why not just try it again, right?
I mean, why not? Such a big, long, explosive run. You think, Jesse, maybe give it to him again? Or do you say, hey, QB, throw that thing out there.
I think you keep it on the ground, David. Honestly, I was watching the offensive line. They were fired up after that long touchdown run. You know they just want to go back out there again and get some push.
He's now got 78 yards rushing already here in the first half. It's a season opener, but he's in midseason form. Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs. Looking to throw, it's Lagway. Throws to the tight end. And they couldn't make the connection on the long shot. They'll try again on second down after the incompletion. He's looking to throw. Unloads to the wideout. And how about that DB getting a hand in there and forcing the incomplete pass? Just a few seconds remaining here as they try to put something up before halftime. On third and long, he's going to have to throw for it. Headed to the end zone. Touchdown, Gators! And they add six more to the board with that trip to the house. Timing and better execution, that is just what a quarterback and wide receiver need.
And it's timing, it's route running, right? You got to be precise. You got to know exactly what yard you're running to. The quarterback receiver on the same page. That's why you get the touchdown.
Get that touchdown right before the half, build the momentum, and the last thing you need to do is mess it up by allowing a big kickoff return. On the run from inside his own five. And the returner goes down. They'll come out and take a knee, and that should send us to halftime. That's the end of the second quarter. That means it's time to join Kevin in our halftime update.
Guys, time for everyone inside that stadium in Dallas to take a deep breath and kind of digest what we just saw. It's been a fun start to this one, and this offense has really been the story. They've opened up a sizable lead, and unless something drastic changes, things might get even more out of hand. A combination of lethal efficiency, and that offensive line has been the key. They've mauled that defense and also just about broken their will. And with that, let's send it back to the guys at Gerald J. Ford Stadium.
Thanks for that breakdown, Kevin. The Mustangs will kick it off to start the second half. No return coming. He'll call for the fair catch. Gators sending the offense back to work. Looking for a productive play on first down. Wasting no time throwing on this drive. And he can't make the connection on his first attempt. Last incompletion leaves them still sitting at their own 25 with second and 10. Now the play fake. Looking to the big tight end. All kinds of room to throw that one in there. And the explosiveness, the big gainer gets it to the 49-yard line. His offense lines up feeling awfully good after that big play. Give to the back. And the defense stops him just short of the first down. Maybe needed a few more chain links to move the sticks. And still a few inches short of the sticks as they come to the line for second down. He's looking to throw. Grabbed over the middle. It's Livingston. And they'll finally catch up to him, but not before a big chunk of yardage is picked up. Last couple of plays, the offense seems to be just one step ahead, David.
Yeah, and I'm going to have to do something to disrupt the timing, the rhythm. I got to do something that they're not expecting, because right now they got the run and they got the pass working. So this defense, they're going to have to find something new to kind of confuse this offense.
The give to the back.
Listen, you got to be able to know what play to call and what hole to go through. Like, the line blocks for a certain hole. Good job getting through the hole, getting on this block, getting a nice positive gain, making your situation really good on the next down.
Going to work in the red zone, they can't pick up the first down without getting it into the end zone. The give to the tailback. Snowed under after a pickup of two. They'll park it at the 8. Boy, they love to move the sticks here and take a shot at it on first and goal. On third and short, they'll try to pick it up with the pass. Fires into the end zone. It falls incomplete. He was trying to find his man for 6. Now on fourth down, they'll settle for a field goal try. Didn't make him sweat at all. It's good. Well, that's just piling on. Not the penalty kind, just the mean kind. They're really starting to extend that lead as they get ready to kick it away again. Looks as if the returner will try and field this one. And the coverage team able to wrestle him down. The Mustangs have the ball back and ready to go to work. From the gun, the ground game. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
It's been that kind of day for this offense, right? It seems like anything they're dialing up just simply isn't working. But at this point, David, I don't know if it's even worth trying to run the ball.
Probably not. You're getting destroyed right now. Nothing has gone your way. And when you're down this much, I think the running game is used sporadically, not as a staple. Let's throw this football around and see what can happen.
They'll give it to Johnson. That hole closed quickly, a pickup of 1 to the 15.
I never know if it's grammatically correct to say a team is being out-physical. You hear it a lot in football, though. That's happening in this game. They are just not getting the push they need all game long up front to have any success when they decide to run it.
This defense has kept them backed up. Now one more stop, and they can get off the field on third and long. And the pass is intercepted. Got some room to run. And he's going to take it all the way. Touchdown, Florida. The DB saw it. He thought, don't drop it, don't drop it. Then thought, don't get caught, don't get caught. And he didn't. The pick 6.
Hey, these guys can play offense, too, now. Look at this. I showed you I can be a wide receiver. Coach might split him out at wide receiver next week after making that big play. But defense, great job making the interception. And you're right. Doing something with it. Don't just slide down. Don't be content. Take that thing all the way back.
Let's go to the studio now and check in with Kevin Connors. Kevin, what do you got?
All right, guys, a little update on what else is happening in college football this weekend. Purdue is putting on an offensive clinic. They've built a big lead, and this one is approaching blowout territory. They're up by 24 over USC. We promise to keep you posted on what goes down in this exciting college football matchup.
Oh, and how about that? I know Kevin and those guys will be keeping an eye on it for us. He thought about bringing that out for a half second, but he'll take a knee and they'll bring it to the 25. The SMU offense is headed back onto the field. Well, the good news is they threw a touchdown pass last time. It was just to the wrong team, Jesse.
Well, that's an unfortunate part.
And the ball is intercepted. Just a short return, but that would have been icing on the cake. They've got it first down at the 42. Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs. The give from the gun. They'll pick up four, second and six coming.
When you're a defense, it is stop the run first. That is your first responsibility. It makes the whole game easy. And right now, they got it going on the ground. The defense is going to have to change something up. These little tiny dink and dunk, you keep doing this, they'll go all the way down the field on you, so you might want to get a little bit more aggressive.
Right back to him on the ground. Brought down just outside the red zone. He moves the chains. It's at the 22.
And this guy is elite. There's a reason why he starts in this offense. You just saw the speed and the open field running ability on that last play. And this is a guy that is going to be key to the entire season for this offense.
The offense down to the 22 on first and 10. The give to the left. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple.
Yeah, and listen, the offense has had their way, and they've had so much success and so much production. But listen, at least the defense got a rep. You know, maybe this gets you a spark. Maybe this gets you some energy. Maybe we'll see a little bit more life from this defense.
Yeah, they may not win the game, but I think this defensive coaching staff at this point, based on how this game has gone, they're just trying to find things to build off of. And maybe that's something they can point to as they get ready for their next opponent, of things they did right and things that they got to do more consistently moving forward.
We've come to the end of the quarter, and it's Florida on top. This has been a complete obliteration so far, as the third quarter stats will show you. So will the beatdown continue, or is this a comeback for the ages in store? We'll see as we start the fourth. About to snap it on second down. Here we go. Quick timeout call by the offense after the play.
Timeout, Florida.
Quarterback reacting to what the D is showing. This offense has a second down play. Wide receiver shows motion. They think they can impose their will here with the run to the right. And it is a good idea to gang tackle. First guy couldn't get him. Second guy finally did. And the Gators have it in scoring position on first and goal. They'll try to get it in with the run. Touchdown, Gators! And the stomping has commenced.
And I just love what I'm seeing from this team. Like, going on the road, game one, where you're still figuring out who you are and what you do well. Another scoring drive by this offense. Looks like they're going to get the dub in a hostile environment to start the season.
And the extra point just tacks a little bit more onto this huge lead. A very efficient five-play scoring drive. And what a way to finish it with a 9-yard touchdown run. The kickoff unit about to go to work.
Set to kick it away.
He'll bring it back from inside his five. Nice job by the kickoff team. Everybody stayed in their lanes and they'll stop him at the 16. The Mustangs have the ball back and ready to go to work. Well, let's see if this drive goes better than the last one. They were in and out quickly after the quick pick, David.
Yeah, first play. Big mistake, man. Now, let's get this offense in a little bit of a rhythm. Maybe before you open it up again, Palmer, or do you trust him right away?
He seems to me like the guy maybe that just needs to kind of get into the flow of the game. So maybe you get the running game going here and just give him some easy looks to let him get lathered up.
Line getting set on second down. Scanning the field, it's Stone. They're bringing heat. And here's a fumble way behind the line. Oh, and he gets it back, so you can file that one under. Could have been worse. You make up the game plan and not a lot on the play sheet for this. Third and long from inside their own 20. Looking to throw, and he needs a chunk play.
And they get him again. This has not been the day we expected. This young man, we expect great things. Like, he is one of the better players in college football. You think he'd come out, put on a show, but this defense has had his number all game long.
Boy, that seemed to be prime return territory, but instead, he'll set the offense up with great field position.
29, Philly. 2-9.
The handoff, keep working on that clock. Crosses the 30, he's got away. Touchdown, Florida! And the route is on.
And everybody's getting in on the fun now for this offense. From the opening whistle, they have been up and down the field. Starters are scoring. You've got backups in the game now. And I love the play calling. These guys came to your school to play in this offense, to score touchdowns. So let them go do it. Make this defense prove they can stop you.
The returner will field it and bring it back. Rolling the dice to bring it out of the end zone did not work out as he stopped at the 13. The SMU offense is headed back onto the field. Boy, three and out last time, Davey. They'd like to be more productive this time around.
Yeah, in the last drive, nothing really clicked. No rhythm. Got off the field really, really quickly. They need to put something together here, Palmer.
Yeah, David, bad execution on that last drive. So they got to take a collective breath and start playing like a unit on this drive.
On second down, looking to throw. Pressure coming. What a complete disaster. What a terrible decision to run that far backwards and take the safety. So after taking the safety, they'll line up for a free kick from their own 20. Florida has the ball back, and here comes the offense. This has been exactly the way you draw things up, David. The offense has really been moving the football.
And it's been great execution. They've done exactly what they've wanted to do. Build the lead. Now Palmer's a different animal. Now you got to protect it.
You can tell they were paying attention in practice this week in the film room because they have gone out everybody right now on the same page.
And he finds some solid space, makes a nice game before the defense is able to stop him.
And how good does that feel, right? You've got the lead in the fourth quarter. The defense knows you're going to try to run the ball to ice the game, and you rip off an 8-yard run. They know it's coming, and they still can't stop it.
Got eight on first down, now looking at a second and two.
Cobra! Freedom! Freedom!
They'll leave it with him. And he'll be taken down, but he does have enough for the first down. Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs.
This guy's been special today. Coming into this one, they thought they had an opportunity really to get him going, running the football, and he has delivered. You've seen the speed, the vision, his ability to break tackles. Well over 100 rushing yards in this game, and that's why they have a nice lead here late.
We've reached the two-minute warning, and this offense is that much closer to salting away a victory. Give to the running back. He had all kinds of company as soon as he got it. He had to fight his way back just to get to the line of scrimmage. Got stuffed on first down. It's second and 10. On the run, it's Webb. Picks up the first down, still moving. And he's brought down after a nice game.
Offense has a huge lead right now in the fourth quarter, and they're just going to run this football to try to ice the game, being more dominant, being more physical at the point of attack.
The Gators come to the line with a fresh set of downs. The give on the inside. And he does a really nice job finding open space and making a good gain before the stop is made.
And there's nothing more frustrating than when you get late in the game and you know they're running the football and you don't stop them. It's been that kind of day for this defense. They haven't played well. They're going to have to go to the well. They're going to have to figure some things out. Practice this week, I can promise you, will not be a lot of fun with these coaches.
Good spot after that 7-yard pickup on first down. It's second and 3. We've waited so long to start the season, and just the way you want to start, getting that first victory.
And the first games are so much fun. You've been practicing against each other over and over all through camp. Now you get to come out, start the season off 1-0, Jesse. Great start.
It was a great start for the winning team. Now, for the losing team, obviously, not the way you want to get into this season. There were some mistakes with execution, and guys are going to have to do a better job individually. But that's why you play the games. You get to now go back to the drawing board, get back on the practice field, try and iron out these wrinkles. It's a long season ahead. A lot to play for.
That's going to do it for us from here. For Jesse Palmer, Dave Pollock, I'm Reese Davis, and this has been another presentation of EA Sports College Football.